You're listening to Why You Suck in Bed on the Riotcast Network, riotcast.com.
Did he smell like money?
He did.
Did his balls taste like money?
Your dicks taste like a crisp $100 bill. Everybody, welcome to Why You Suck in Bed. Thank you for joining us for our annual holiday episode. Christmas, Kwanzaa, Hanukkah, whatever your denomination may be. We appreciate you listening. What you got there, pal? Is that Hitler?
Yeah, that's Hitler.
Indeed it is.
Well, what a fine time of year
it's
to bring up a
picture. It's a
Mary Jerry. It's a Hitler orgy.
I almost said Merry Jerry Christmas.
Merry Jerry Christmas?
Yeah, like, I don't know.
Like...
Have a holly jolly Christmas.
Nothing says holidays like the Nazis.
Yeah, Nazis.
Warms my heart.
What you doing? You gonna fuck your stable? Are you going to get a sleigh? Strap up your six studs.
Like reindeer.
Naked.
That is the best idea ever.
What's their reindeer name?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, can we give each of your studs a reindeer name?
Yes.
Like, which one would be...
But there's only six.
Right.
I have to add two more. No. Is it eight reindeer?
Oh, yeah, there is. Oh, and technically nine.
Yeah.
Because you got Rudolph.
What would make Rudolph?
That would be your boy. That would be your...
That'd be
your
the number one
stud would have to be Rudolph.
That'd be the Southern Gentleman.
Yeah.
We have to paint his dick red?
Yes. And he would have to lead with his dick.
Oh, my God.
So it would have to stay hard the whole time.
And it would have to light up.
Right. Do you sell those? Do you sell, like, light up?
I'm sure I have something. If not, I'll build it.
Light up dickheads.
So I'm essentially going to take, the six guys in my stable and make them into reindeer. But I would have to have seven to put him out front.
Out front, yeah. Mm. So we need...
We got Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, Blitzen.
TP, you want to come back into the fold?
Sure. You want to enter the stable?
Done!
Let me be Blitzen.
You want to be Blitzen?
You could be Quimby.
So it is written, so it shall be done. I've got some reindeer costumes I got to go buy. This might be the best idea you've ever come up with.
They should be butt naked with just the antlers.
Just the antlers?
Just antlers.
Oh,
except for Rudolph with his...
Oh! And each one of them is wearing vibrating panties.
Why would they want to wear vibrating panties?
You're controlling.
I have like six, seven controllers. Yeah,
you're like, hey, Blitzen, pick it up a bit.
Like an apartment super with all the keys. You got all the...
I see you.
I've got them on a ring.
I see you down there, Rudolph, not pulling your weight.
Hey, that's Comet. You're hitting the wrong one.
Get your dick out of Blitzen's ass.
No, none of that's allowed to happen.
Exactly.
There's no man-on-man contact in my stable.
That's why you're buzzing them with your Bluetoother.
My Bluetoother?
Yeah, you could have like, there you go. You have like seven different apps going at the same time.
Oh, such a good idea. Amazing.
You would need a keyboard in front of you, like this kind of a thing. And you'd be like,
yeah, you need a MIDI controller.
Are we playing Simon? What the hell was that? How much did Simon infuriate you? That was like the worst thing.
Terrible game.
It was bad. I remember like launching that thing like a frisbee across the room.
And what's sad is I kind of bought something like that for my son a number of years ago. It kind of looks like a Simon, but it has different color things with instrument pictures on them. And when he, like, it was when he was a baby, and when you press like the yellow one, then a song would play, and when you press the red one, a different song would play.
That's amazing. Anyways,
I just got cut off.
And then any of our listeners that's under the age of 30 has no idea what the fuck Simon is anyways.
Oh, do we have a lot of really young listeners?
We do have some. We do have some.
Cool. We got the young generation coming in.
God bless them. They're probably all having more sex than we are.
I'm doing pretty well with that. And you have six fucking studs. What are you talking
about? That's true. Well, that's just this time in my life.
You're getting filled all over the place.
I almost did add a seventh recently.
Was it another Tinder guy?
No.
You're off of that.
No, I'm done with Tinder because it's just, I've got enough to handle right now.
Was this a guy you met like at a show or something?
No, I was on the train coming back from Manhattan, and for some reason I attract suits. You know, like, what was that?
It's Simon.
Oh God, that just takes me back to like just being so angry.
I hate the low one. It was like,
I know, it vibrates you.
What's the noise when you lose? It's like, it's like, fuck you.
It's like the brown note.
Yes, that's exactly
when
what
you
it was.
Shit yourself.
Best game was Chutes and Ladders.
Oh, Chutes and Ladders was good. Candyland was good too. Candyland was the shit.
I never owned Candyland.
Well, Chutes and Ladders, you could really be a dick and like send somebody down the chute.
There was that one opponent right by the winning slot that took you all the way back to the beginning.
Yeah, you could really be a douche in that game.
And it actually kind of taught you morals because each of the slides had like a kid fucking robbing a bank. And then you fall down the slide, you end up in jail. And then there was the slide, you know what I mean? Am I making stuff
Are you up? Talking? I'm sorry. How do we keep getting on these horrible non-sexual conversations? You're Simon and Chutes and Ladders. Oh, we're the worst.
I was telling you a story.
I was so excited to tell you this.
Yes. Seventh stud.
This is another.
Is it still a possible?
No.
Possible?
No. I think I'm done with this one, and I'll tell you why.
Okay. So on the train.
So we're on the train, and I attract.
Suit comes over.
I attract men in suits. I think it's something about their life being very boring. Rigid and not maybe
boring.
Not boring,
yes,
you know, rigid.
Boring, and they see a rock star.
And they see me, and you know, I'm like covered in tattoos, and then once they find out I'm in a band, it's just something about our worlds being completely opposite, and I think that's where the attraction
lies.
They come
over and you're like, what's up, baby? I'm a fucking rock star.
Why would I ever say that?
That's what your persona says.
Is that maybe what my persona says?
Maybe you don't verbalize it, but it's there.
Well, anyways, this suit, whose name is Jeremy, sat next to me on the train. Very good-looking investment broker. We're both coming back from Manhattan, and we struck, you know, about the conversation, and the next thing you know, he's like, well, why don't you come for a drink with me? I'm getting off at the next stop. Hop off with me, and we'll go get a drink somewhere, and we'll hang out. I just want to get raped. Is that so bad? Pretty much what I was setting myself up for. So we did. We went and we had a drink, and one thing led to another, and I ended up going back to his house. And
take your bra off.
We had sex. And the next morning, I ended up staying over because I was really shit-faced, which I don't usually do. But the next morning...
Every time she says that, I want you to keep a file.
What?
Of
that
each
I don't...
time that she says, I got really shit-faced, and I don't usually do that.
No, I always get shit-faced, but I don't usually stay over.
Stay over. Okay.
We all know I'm a raging alcoholic. Right, like, that's never come out of my mouth.
I misunderstood, sorry.
You misinterpreted. That's okay. Sorry. So I stayed over his house,
Alcoholism,
and the next morning...
Alcoholism, good. Slut, not good.
The next morning, he made coffee for us, which I thought was very gentlemanly of him. And we're sitting. Well, he had to go to work. He had to go back to the city, and I had to go
be a
dirtbag musician.
At least you
which
got
means I was just going to go home and go back to bed.
Right.
So he's making coffee, and we're sitting in his kitchen, and his place was really nice. So this guy's definitely loaded. And he's like,
it was in Manhattan.
No. He lives on the North Shore. Money, baby.
Hello.
Oh yeah, we got off the Long Island Railroad and got right into his BMW.
Ooh,
and yeah, it was nice.
Very nice stud to have in the stable.
Recently divorced, no children.
Slap me with your penis.
Good looking guy. Definitely not my type, and the sex was mediocre, but whatever, I had a good time. So
you top or he top?
Oh, it was all over the place.
Oh.
Yeah, there was lots of, but you know what? Sometimes changing lots of positions during sex is hot, and sometimes it's just awkward. Sometimes it just feels like Twister.
Yes.
You know, you're just
like,
doing too much.
Move your leg there.
I think he felt like, because it was the first time we slept together, like he really had to like bring the noise, you know, and like make it, and whatever, you know.
He's like, go over here, put your leg over there, then I'll do you.
Yeah, it was okay. It wasn't awful. It was like, you know, anyways.
You got off.
So we're having coffee.
You
and he
you
says.
You got off while you were having coffee?
No, stop interrupting me. Jesus.
How many times did he get off?
Once. It was a one-shot deal. It was, yeah. So we're having coffee, and he says to me, he's like, I realize this is really forward. He's like, but do you have any plans tomorrow night? I says, well, I do. I said, why? What you got going on? Mm. He's like, well, one of my friends is having a really exclusive dinner party, and I have to bring a date. And he's like, I think everybody would really be interested in you and your lifestyle. And he's like, I think you should come. He's like, I think it'd be really fun. So I did kind of have plans. I think it was with number four, but we didn't have anything set. So I was a little intrigued. So I was like, well, maybe, you know. He's like, well, that's it's not just a dinner party. He's like, it's a swingers party. He says, my wife and I used to hang out with this group of people, and we would go to swingers parties, and we would swap. So I'm like, fuck it, let's go.
Now, did he buy you a little dress and then snap the jewelry thing at you?
And I laughed. I was like, yeah. No, it's
said,
definitely not a
and
pretty
you said,
woman
I'll
situation.
Do everything except kiss you, like that. No.
So I had a lot of questions because I've never been to a swingers party before, and basically how he presented to me is that this is something that this group of people does with each other. It's like eight couples. They've all been with each other, and his wife used to be a player.
I want to interrupt you one more time.
Go ahead.
Because
at least you asked permission this time.
I did not realize that we were in the swinger story. I knew there was a swinger story coming.
Well, now we're here.
And now I know that we're in the swinger story, and I just got tingles.
You just got tingles?
Yes, I just got excited.
Where'd you get the tingle?
Like the bottom of my testicles.
Right, in like the lower echelon. Yes. That's cool. But do you want me to continue, or do you want me to just leave you with
balls? I thought this was just a story, but this is the swinger
story. This is the swinger story.
Shit. Everyone listen. Strap in. Because this is
don't build it
story.
Up too much, all right?
I'm turning myself
towards
so
you.
I'm totally
all right.
focused.
So let me just cut to the story. So I asked...
tell it.
I know that this is going to be a high society... These are all investment bankers, Wall Street people that he's friends with. It's on a house in the North Shore. Oh, yeah, these people can make it rain, definitely. So I asked him, well, how should I dress? You know, should I wear, you know, like a nice dress? Or he's like, just be yourself. He's like, I'm bringing you there.
wear a bunny suit. Do you have any unicorn?
I do. I could have worn my unicorn costume.
Or what was it, a cow?
The cow, exactly. Anyways, so cut to two nights later. He specifically told me, like, dress like you would, you know, wear a nice dress, but be yourself. He's like, I want you to go as you. So I was like, okay. So I just wore like a little black cocktail dress. You know, all my tattoos were out and everything like that.
Blazing, fucking blazing.
So he picks me up and we go to this party, and it's, again, it's on the North Shore. I'm thinking like Billy Joel neighborhood, like money.
Yeah.
Like houses with gates.
Gated areas. Yes, I dated a girl.
We pull up to the house. Snooty. It looks like the Playboy Mansion outside. Nice. There's like BMW, Mercedes, yes. Audi in the parking lot. So I'm like, okay, this is going to be interesting. So we walk in, and I'm nervous at this point because right. not only am I've never been to a swingers party, I'm walking into a room full of people I don't know,
and they're all filthy rich. Bunch of richers.
So we walk in. It's about 16 to 20 people, all couples. Everybody's nicely dressed. All the women are pretty. They're all very well manicured. I immediately start sweating.
They're not wearing masks or anything?
No, it's not like Eyes Wide Shut.
All right.
And everybody's happy to see each other. They're all hugging, kissing on the cheek. You know, here, let me get you a martini.
Oh, hello. Come on in. Hello.
So Jeremy proceeds to take me around and introduce me to everybody. And it feels so awkward because I know I'm being sized up. Right. You know, like, I know all the men are like, and these are all waspy, you know, super white Republican.
Yeah.
All good looking people.
Like, this one probably puts out.
So obviously it's something where you definitely want to have some drinks. So we have like, you know, we sit down, we all have dinner together. Everybody's laughing. They're all talking about, then the boat and the office today.
And I made another $1 million.
I swear to God, that's an accurate depiction of how it was. Like, they're laughing about things. I have no idea what they're talking about.
And then the banker said.
So the wife of the gentleman that, the wife of who's the owner of the house, her and her husband.
Paige, can you please tell
Paige, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Tell us about your exciting job. We hear you're like one of those musicians.
Were you there? It's like exactly what they sounded like.
And you must
oh,
be.
Muffy.
Oh, Muffy. Buffy.
Tad, come here.
Tad. Yes, Tad.
You must be the Monopoly guy.
Thanks for the free part.
So we're sitting at this long, elegant table in this beautiful dining room with a chandelier, and everybody's tipsy. Like, everybody's drinking martinis. Everybody's drinking champagne. Paige, tell us about yourself. Tell us about your life. Tell us about being a musician. So I'm already pretty well lubricated at this point. I've had a few martinis. I'm feeling pretty good. So I tell them about, you know, how I'm a drummer and how I own a sex toy company. And they're all riveted because this is a lifestyle that none of them have ever experienced
no
before.
Guests.
So I can already tell by the looks in all the men's eyes, there's going to be
a little glimmer.
Yeah.
Did they all pop up at the same time? Like, all the... all the lights and all the penises went up, like,
and all the vaginas dried up.
And all the vaginas were like, what a slutty
bitch.
What
a slut. She probably got that dress from Macy's.
Yeah.
What a poor person.
Would you like to borrow a real dress? That looks like something you'd buy from Target.
So anyways, I realized at that point I had the power. So I started really assessing.
I got the power.
I hate telling stories. It's impossible.
It still sounds like I'd wide shut.
So I realize at that point I've got my pick of the litter. So I start really assessing the guys that are sitting at the table. Most of them are borderline handsome. Borderline. Kind of. And I think it's just because I'm just not attracted to that kind of guy.
More or less than the dude you went with. Like, could you have upgraded?
I could. Yes. And I thought I did.
Okay.
So anyways, dinner is over. More drinks. Everybody goes to, like, I guess you would call it the parlor or
what
whatever.
What was dinner? Was it like
stuffed partridge?
No, it was like a chicken dish of some sort. It was served to us, I can tell you that much.
In, like, silver nipple things?
Silver. Oh, you mean, like, with the cover?
Cloche?
No. Wow.
Look at this fucking guy.
It's not like Mr. Belvedere was there, but, I mean, they did have a servant that brought the food out and a chef that cooked for the dinner party and everything. It was very highfalutin.
Pheasant. It's quite pleasant.
It wasn't pheasant. It was like a chicken dish. Obviously, they're not going to serve anything too heavy because everybody's going to be fucking later.
Hanging from the chandelier.
Yeah, exactly. All right, so I can tell it's that point of the evening. Everybody's been fed. Everybody's had quite a few drinks at this point, and everybody's loose. So at that point, men start approaching me with their wives sometimes to come over and talk a little bit more and be a little bit more personal and come over and just be like, hey, you know, I'm really curious about you, or I'm really interested in you. And do you think maybe we can go somewhere and talk a little bit more? And I'd be like, well, I'm, you know, this is my first time. So I'm just trying to, you know, get comfortable with the situation. And
were they being like,
they weren't being aggressive. It was all very nonchalant. Like, right. 'Cause these people have all been fucking each other for God knows how long.
So there's no, what are any like if you didn't know that you were at a swinger party,
mm-hmm.
would you know that they were making passes? Like that they were.
Yeah. 'Cause it was a little obvious, especially at that point in the evening. They're pretty much in a nice, proper way we're saying, I want to fuck you.
Hey, come over here.
Can I lure you into another room?
Mm.
But I knew not to go with the first offer. So right. I waited.
You got to shop around.
You got to shop around. So I waited. So this gentleman comes over, and his wife was a knockout. He comes over to me by himself, and he was just very, there's just something about him that was very.
Dapper Dan?
Dapper Dan, cool. Like, not like any person I've ever slept with before, just like very, very Wall Street. He had a sweater vest on.
Short sleeve or long sleeve?
No, he had.
Oh, vest.
He had the sweater vest.
Vest.
Yeah.
Okay.
With the long sleeve shirt
long
with the cuffs.
Long sleeve shirt underneath.
Yeah.
Diamond cufflinks.
Brooks Brothers,
nice.
You know, head to toe.
Did
so he comes
did he
over.
He waltz
and
over?
He like, didn't waltz. He kind of sashayed over. But he was, you know, tall, rugged, just very good looking guy. And there's just something about him that I liked. It might have just been because I was drunk. So I look past him and I see his wife looking at me, and I thought
with daggers?
I thought she was daggering me. I thought she was grilling me.
Right.
She winked at me. So that was, I took that as the
that's the
as
end.
The go ahead.
So that was, you're like, okay,
shopped around enough.
Right. And Jeremy's gone. My date, he's already gone. He's already in a room with somebody else. Yeah, well, we're not supposed to sleep together. The whole idea is to swap and sleep with somebody else.
But I thought they don't do, like, couple swaps? You just split
no,
up?
No, everyone just splits. Free game. It
swing,
is free game.
Swing wherever you may swing.
Really?
Yeah.
Because I was assuming it was like you found a couple and then you did like a...
No, this was fair game.
So
like, you could sleep...
It's like one, you walk two, into three, that party, break up, go.
Yeah, it was like you walk into the party and you could sleep with whoever you want.
Nice. 52 pickup.
Wow. Yeah, that's a fucking good deal.
And 22 so, skidoo.
So wait, if I take the first offer, right?
Yeah.
And then I finish up and I run back in the room.
Can I get seconds? I don't know. And that was something I was curious about, too.
Because especially for you chicks, because you can, like I got to wait at least a half hour to reload. I mean, you could probably walk right out and just pick up another dick and...
I don't know.
Bing, bada, boom.
Slap a poos.
Or does that make you...
Slap a poos.
Does that make you the slut of the swinger party?
I don't know. See, I don't know what the rules are. Yes. I've never been involved in the swinger. And they refer to it as the lifestyle.
Yeah, that sounds like a cat.
That was new for me, too. Have you heard that before? Oh, she did. Okay.
She did call it that.
That was the first time I've ever delved into that world. But basically, we're dealing with a whole room full of rich, bored people.
That's hot.
Just bored. Just...
And you are the most exciting thing that's walked in a while.
Oh, absolutely. I was like...
You got...
I was like the wild card. Yeah, I had the tattoos. I'm a musician. I own a sex toy business. So they were just like... Oh my God!
They were probably
it was like they brought the elephant man in there or something. You know? Like, wow!
I bet
this
you,
freak.
I bet you, your boy.
Look at this freak! Yeah, exactly.
Your boy was getting compliments. Like, where to bring in that one? Way to go, Jeremy!
I didn't know you went on that side of the truck.
Exactly.
You must have went to that biker bar and picked up one of those floozies.
Floozy. But I wasn't treated like a floozy. I was treated with like total respect by
these
people.
Because they wanted to fuck you.
Well, exactly. How they talked about... I'm probably like the laughing stock now. They'll probably get together.
I wouldn't say laughing stock. They're probably like, oh, are you going to bring that loosey-goosey again?
Loosey-goosey.
I didn't get to play on that ride. I'd like a spin on that wheel, please.
So, the gentleman that I was speaking of, I don't even know what his name is. We went into...
Just you and he.
Just him and I.
He and you. You and he.
Me and this guy. We went down this hallway, we found a bedroom, and we sat on the bed, and that was it. He just started kissing me, and...
The royal penis is clean, your
okay,
highness.
So you were in a dining room place, right? You moved to a different room for the schmoozing before the bedding?
No, the schmoozing happens right out in the open with everybody. I mean, like, he kind of pulled me off to
Where
the side
beds,
a little bit. There's probably 10 bedrooms in this house, if not more. This place
so
is
So you
humongous.
Just went, like, upstairs or somewhere?
Yeah, we went down a corridor away from the dining area or the parlor or whatever you want to call it.
And you just opened a random door.
He knew where to go. He's the one. He took me by the hand and brought me right in there.
I wonder if the doors, if like the room that your boy's in, like do they put a sock on? Like, did,
oh,
do they have
a?
Do they
I didn't
have,
think. I was so like overwhelmed by the whole situation.
There's a green and red.
There's an Argyle sock hanging on the
like,
door.
They put like
light changes.
They put like,
in the like airplane
a.
Bath.
They put like a dead bald eagle on the door knob so that you know not to go in.
They can afford it.
Right. Exactly.
So he takes me by the hand. This is after we chatted for a little bit, and I was just like, okay, this is the one. So he takes me by the hand. And he takes me down this hallway. We go into this room, and he starts to kiss me, and like we take each other's clothes off, and he's a good-looking guy.
You fuck like, me now in bathroom.
Probably late 30s, early 40s, good build. You can tell he goes to the gym.
Did he smell like money?
He did.
Did his balls taste like money?
Your dicks taste like a crisp $100 bill. He takes his underwear off.
Do you take his underwear off and fucking, like, $100 bills fall out?
It makes that noise when his penis comes out.
When he comes.
When he comes.
And then you get hit in the head with coins.
Okay, I'm ready. Let's go.
Oh, my God.
And his balls look like two money bags with dollars on them.
Oh, it just gets better.
So you're taking down his underwears.
We're taking each other's clothes off. We're kissing each other. We're touching each other.
And he has expensive undergarments on.
I'm sure.
Like,
the light was dim, but I'm guessing it was all like Gucci and just very nice. He takes his shorts down. He has the smallest penis I've ever seen in my entire life. like baby carrot.
Was it erect?
Yeah.
Oh,
it was
so
tiny.
It wasn't even a
grower.
And
you know what? That kind of shot my whole like theory down of like, I feel like guys with big dicks carry themselves a certain way. They have a certain kind of swagger
but
to
if
them.
If you have enough money, you can make up for
that's
the swagger.
Exactly that, how I, this. That's exactly how I summed it up, because this guy is fucking loaded. He can fuck whoever he wants,
right.
I'm sure.
Whenever he wants. He's
exactly.
still fucking you, regardless of how right. tiny his dick is, and he never has to see you again.
But he's taking my clothes off, and he's like, oh my God, look how many tattoos you have. Like, you can tell he's just like, I've never had sex with somebody like this before.
Right.
So, you know, you make the best of it. You know, I
now completely erect.
Completely erect.
Give me, what, 2 inches?
That's about 3.
All right, maybe, yeah. Maybe
about 3 inches. Like,
three
to the
inches.
Fact that his balls look enormous because his penis is so tiny.
How thick we talking?
It did have some girth, I will say that.
Like this?
Like, probably like a kielbasa girth. Maybe a little bigger.
Because that's not super wide.
No.
That's I would say that's kind of average width, right? Look at her penis.
Yes.
Look at my penis circumference.
Look at the hand. You ever play that game in
Let
school?
Let me get my penis circumference chart out.
You ever play that game where you would make a circle, and if someone looked at it, then you could
yes,
punch them?
Yes, exactly.
That's what it looked like you were playing with the...
Look at this.
You were doing the penis game. Yeah, the penis game. Look at my girth. So, but that doesn't look like super wide. Like I'm thinking, like if it's that small, I would think it would have to be soda can.
Like a fucking soda can.
Yeah,
well, that would be nice. Yeah, right. But it wasn't the case at all. He had a tiny dick.
So was it one of those like, is it in yet? You didn't feel a thing, did you?
I'm not. I don't want to portray myself as somebody with
you
a
still
vagina
got
that's like a hallway.
You still got off? Mm-mm. No, you didn't. No.
He
Wait,
did.
Pause.
He did.
Of course he did.
He did. He loved him. He loved it. I rode him like a champ. But it was just like nothing. It was like straddling
that's
a...
so disappointing.
2x4.
That sucks.
But so, here's what. You know, and after it was all done, we got cleaned up. We were... And he was such a gentleman. Like, you could tell he's definitely like a blue blood, you know, because he was like very polite. And I appreciated
and
that he
bled blue all over you.
He came green.
He bled
he
out
came,
of his...
He came. His cum was gold.
It was coin. It was literally coins. His
it
sperm,
was literally. His,
he had coins coming out of his dick. It was like a slot machine when you hit the jackpot.
He made it rain all over me. But after it was all over, you know, it was fine. We got dressed. We got cleaned up. And when we went back out into the party, he kind of was like. Made it seem like, okay, I got to go find my wife. And right. I was like, okay.
See you later.
Peace out. See right. you later. Thanks for the disappointing dick.
Right.
And everybody was gone. Like, everybody was out in other rooms or had gone home. So the wife of the house came out in her bathrobe. And she was just like, oh, hey. You know, she's like, you know, can I make you a drink? Or did you have a good time? And I was like, oh, yeah. You know, I wasn't going to be like, you know.
He had a little
homeboy
dick.
Had a tiny dick, but
right.
she probably knows.
I
want to
return that dick.
I want a dick refund.
She's probably fucked up. I would like to return the dick, please.
Do you have a golden vibrator I can borrow? Because I didn't get off.
But she was very nice, and she called me a cab so I could go home. And I left.
Really?
Yeah, I left Jeremy
your
behind.
Guy completely disappeared.
I was just so uncomfortable at that point. Like, it just the whole thing just felt so strange.
What time was it at this point? Are we
probably
talking really
like,
late?
No, like 1 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, it wasn't even.
No.
Because I would wonder, like, if you sat there long enough, would someone else mosey out of their room?
I thought about that as I was leaving.
Another...
I thought about that as I was leaving, but I was just like, you know what? I don't want to get passed around this party. It's just kind of
right. You don't want to find out that every guy has a little
dick. Dick. That's right. What I was afraid of. So I went, she called me a cab and she gave me a hug. She was super sweet and she just kind of sent me on my way and I went home and I got cleaned up and I went out.
And masturbated.
I went out. I just kind of wanted to put the experience behind me.
Do you get like blue ovaries after that? I mean like...
Sort of. Yeah, you always you have this thing in the back of your mind. It's not physical like you guys get blue balls. I think it's like a mental thing for us.
Blue
like,
lips?
Not blue lips either. It's just you want... You were like waiting for it and it didn't happen. So you've kind of got that cliffhanger.
Right.
You want it to happen.
I've gone on record as saying that I don't believe in blue balls, that they don't really exist. Guys use that as an excuse to get sex.
Okay.
So I imagine it's the same feeling that you're describing right
so
now.
So you think it's more of a mental thing?
Yes.
Like for me, it's a mental thing. Yes. It's not a physical thing.
Yeah, like if I have a hard-on and I think I'm going to get sex and I don't get sex, like that sucks. But my balls don't hurt as a result.
And what sucks is I think I was more aroused by the excitement of being in an uncomfortable situation like that than I was by him. You know, his body was great and everything, but...
Right. Because this is, this is an exciting thing that you've never done before.
Yeah.
Right.
And I have to learn my lesson because every time I put myself in these weird situations, it always ends bad. I need to just stick with what I know.
I wouldn't say that, but that's not bad. I would say disappointing. Mm,
exactly. It wasn't bad. If I saw these people out, which would never happen because we live in totally different worlds, but if I ever saw these people out, I would go up to them and say hello,
Hey, what's up? Would you do that again? Would you do another swinger party?
Maybe. I mean, I think if I was in a comfortable relationship with somebody that I had been with and we were getting to that point where things were starting to get a little boring, I think I would do it. But I wouldn't just go with a random guy again, like that guy Jeremy.
I was going to ask you, so did you ever hear from him again?
Yeah, he called me the next day. Yeah. He just wanted to make sure that I got home okay, and he apologized because he was with somebody.
Right.
You know, whatever. That's the reason that we went there.
Right.
And it was kind of like, I guess I'll see you when I see you, and so on and so forth.
Was his dick big? Because you said it was mediocre,
the sex was mediocre.
Was the dick?
It was average.
So, okay, so it was bigger than...
Definitely.
Richie McRicherson.
Oh, yeah.
Huh. So you wouldn't... So that was it. You talked to him, and it was like, and that's it.
Yeah.
Because
I like the boys in my stable to have a little grit, I'm not, like, totally attracted to that kind of guy, like the suit. Works on Wall Street, doesn't really have a sense of humor.
See, I'm putting myself in that situation, and I'm thinking if I had a chick that I had a hook up to a swinger party like
you would have loved it.
Well, that's what
I'm
saying.
From the guy's perspective, all the women were beautiful.
That's what I'm
saying.
Like,
waspy, rich, bored housewives.
Like, even if I couldn't stand the chick or wasn't, like, really good with the, like, I would want to be in, I would want that hook up to call her up and be like, hey, you got another one of those parties coming up?
Mm-hmm.
I'll totally...
I might hear from him again. This is only like a week and a half, 2 weeks ago. So, I don't know. If you ask
does
me again, I can't
does
say
he want to bring
that
me?
I wouldn't. I'll ask him.
The freak has another freak she wants to bring.
Ew, look at this spazoid. But I would be the stud because I'd whip out my dick.
Exactly. You walk in just like Stifler. Be like, who wants to suck my dick?
Who wants all this shit?
I got diabetes now. Suck all my dick.
I'd walk in with a crocodile.
Crocodile, exactly.
Like, who wants some crocodile, motherfuckers?
Walk in like it's a goddamn frat party.
And I have an average penis size, but it sounds like I would be the big dude there. I'd be like, check out this fucking salama.
Well, I didn't get to compare and contrast with the rest of the party.
Shouldn't they have like a viewing?
Viewing or like some sort of like a color rating, like you wear like a little ribbon, like for like 4 to 6 inches. This guy didn't even fall into that category. Under 4 inches.
Well, sounds like his
4 to 6.
Sounds like I would want a piece of that.
Maybe his wife winked at me like, good luck.
Yeah, have fun with that shit.
Yeah, good luck.
I'm married to that crap.
This is why I come to swingers parties.
Yeah, she probably loves
that. It was probably
that.
Her idea for them to join that
she
little
probably loves
community.
That shit. But then again, he's getting, different vagina, so.
And she's getting different dicks, so everybody wins.
That is true.
Apparently they do it once a month.
That's a good
deal. They get
deal.
Together at
That's
each other's
deal.
Houses, and they just get drunk on really good vodka, and they fuck each other.
As long as they know they can keep it, like...
They seem like...
Like they don't give a fuck?
I didn't ask how long they've been doing it, but they all seem to know each other pretty well.
That's fucking awesome.
I know, right? In retrospect, when you think about it, it really is
that's
awesome.
A good setup.
We're talking about like almost 20 people that are all on the same mindset.
And they're rich, so they're all like in the best like looking that person
Very
can be.
Very much so, exactly.
I'm just happy you got out alive.
Thanks.
So I'm pretty sure they've killed a couple of them.
and ate them as a sacrifice.
Yeah, exactly. Well, whenever
have some of this meat. I can't tell you what it is, but you'll like it.
Well, whenever you're going to walk into a situation like that where you don't know anybody, you make sure at least 2 or 3 people from your camp know what you're up to.
Do you carry
so,
mace?
Typically, yeah.
All right, good for you. I was going to say, I know what to get you for Christmas.
I always have some sort of weapon.
Good.
Mace, knuckles, knife.
Nice. Good. That's my girl. Good girl.
Thanks, buddy.
Looking out for you.
Thanks.
Next time, take me to the party. I'll fuck everyone there.
I think we should just roll in like we own the place and just be like, listen, this is how it's going to go. You're all going to line up. We're all going to take you one at a time.
Yes.
Or maybe two.
No, even better. You find out when the next party is and we just crash with a group of people. Like fucking TP.
Yeah.
Just all fucking roll in.
I wonder if Henry knows these people.
I'll bring my corner shadow.
Yes. Like, everyone will be fucking, and then there'll be TP in the corner, like, yeah.
That's what I was afraid of. I was afraid everybody was going to be fucking in
an
open
room. And you would
be
in the corner?
Yeah, I thought it was going to... No. I was afraid everybody was going to, like... Just it was going to be like open air fucking.
Pile on the rich guy. Pile on the rich guy.
Like gangbang. But it was all very like, it was all very like manners.
Behind closed doors. Let's go to this room. That sounds fucking awesome.
Like, see, now that I'm talking about it, maybe I would go again. Yeah. I know which guy I'm not going to fuck. That's for sure.
Right. You got one down.
One down.
But there were like, you said what, at least 10 other people to choose
from?
They
seemed really entertained by me. Maybe I'll be invited back again. Maybe I should start my own swingers party.
And what you do, okay, so call this dude, right?
Mm-hmm.
Get one more hookup in.
Mm-hmm.
And then... get in when you're there, get in with the hosts and
get a
phone number or get a like a you know contact me
mm-hmm.
and take them aside and be like, listen, contact you know this guy.
Well, let's wait till after the holidays. It's gonna be really busy getting my stable together and reindeer right. costumes for the photo shoot. So
then you can start because then you'll get invited and you can start rolling in with your studs.
Mm. I don't want to share them though. Is that fucked up?
Yeah, because they would probably be popular since they're also other side of the tracks.
Right. They're from my camp.
Right.
They're
from the workhorse camp.
Yeah, they
not
are.
Not the blue blood.
Exactly. No, definitely camp. Not blue blood.
These guys are hung like horses.
Not all of them, but they're definitely
number
all
above. Number one is, though.
They're, oh, yeah.
They're yeah, def- but
they're definitely
that's
all
why
you're
number one.
I'm definitely not taking him to the party.
Right.
He would get eaten alive. Your original idea of just me and you going and just busting in and just being like, this is how it's going to go down.
And no, I want to walk in and just have them, just everyone line up. And then I just pick one. You.
Like going into like an Asian whorehouse.
Yeah.
Where they line up for you. And you.
You.
Just...
You're mine. Let's go.
You with the Brooks Brothers suit.
And you, you're going to sit in a corner and masturbate while we're doing it. you're going to wear panties.
I would feel a lot better if you were there with me. Like if I had somebody in like.
And then we could text each other and be like, are you done yet?
Are
you ready to come out to the main room?
Can you come
swap?
Help me?
can we swap?
Can you come in here and give me a hand?
And then we'll go in the center and we'll just wait for someone else to come out and then we swap. And eventually, like, you know,
this
five.
This is the second good idea you've had this episode.
Five in the morning, we're like fucking completely run down and ragged. Like, my balls are completely empty. Like, your vagina is just fucking worn thin.
Worn thin? It's just worn thin. The wind blows. It's like.
That's like holes in it. It's like
these rich fucks don't know what to do with a pussy. It's all like missionary and.
So you would be disappointed 10 times that I'm coming out.
I
like,
might be. I might be. It's
like,
a concern of mine.
Oh, I have no nuts left.
And you're like, dealing with horny housewives.
I haven't even nut once. I would make out like a bandit there.
Yeah, you would.
I would bring both of TP's crocodiles, and I would have one on each crocodile. Like crocodile, and then I'd have the panties going. I'd bring a whole bunch of the vibrating panties.
The only thing that would make it better, and from my angle, is that I don't know if these blue blood guys are down with oral. Like, I don't know if they know how to go down on a woman.
Mm. I bet you they don't, because I bet you they never had to.
I kind of think that's how it goes.
Sometimes, like, to keep it interesting, you got to go down and do some business. You know?
Yeah, so I might have to go back.
I bet you they would hire someone to do it for them. They'd be like, hey, you, I'll give you $20 to
the
go down
waiter.
On my wife.
Mr. Belvedere.
Oh, porterhouse. Please eat this woman's vagina. Thank you.
Oh, God.
Help. Come over here.
See what you can do with this. I don't understand the technical aspect of all this. Can you assist me?
I did stay in a hotel that looked like this in Belgium.
Once you're done, let me know. Then I'll.
He's
put
not
my
in my
penis.
Anus.
Now, did little dick guy go for a while?
Yeah, it was like a standard amount of time.
Like, what's a standard amount of time? 5 minutes?
No, he went longer than that. It was like 15 to 20.
15, 20 minutes. Of you on top the whole...
No, we switched. We switched a little bit. He started with missionary first, and
get
then
him on top.
Yep, him on top, and then
did he talk at all?
No,
completely quiet.
No, not completely quiet. Like he was like a moaner and a grunter. Yeah, with his little dick. And then I flipped him over, and I got on top in hopes that there would
that
be some
something
sort of
would go on,
something would happen.
Nothing.
Yeah, there was nothing.
Even did you try like touching yourself while?
Oh yeah,
nothing.
But I think I was just so uncomfortable at that point; it wasn't going to happen. So. I faked it.
Did you?
Yeah, yeah. I did.
I guess you kind of have to at that point.
Well, I kind of wanted it. I felt like he was waiting for. He was so intent on me getting off, and he thought he thought he was amazing. Like, you know, I'm asking you. You know when a guy is fucking you and he thinks he's awesome? I'm asking you this question. I'm sorry.
Okay.
I always, yeah,
okay, ask me.
I'm not going to ask because I always think I'm awesome.
No, you know, sometimes guys will be banging you and you could see it in their eyes that they're just into it and they're just like, oh, yeah, take it. And they think they're really good and it's awful.
Right. I know I'm good. So I don't, like, I know
I'm sure
good.
You've had, you know, you've had some people tell you what's up.
I've had, no, actually, my exes will be like, you only made me, you never made me. And I'm like, that's bull. Don't even fucking try that shit. I know.
They come back and they tell you that they.
No, like afterwards, you know, after we break up. But that's the thing is, like, I know what an orgasm feels like. Like, I know what your insides feel like when it's happening.
You must feel like the tightening. Like, you must feel like the pulsing and the.
But also the reaction. Like, if you just go, like.
Are you stabbing them at the same time?
Yeah. Like, sometimes, and each person reacts differently. It's like, you get, yeah, it's hard to explain. You just fucking know. I don't buy any of that shit. I faked it, too. I faked it before.
Have you really?
Yeah, totally faked
it. I always wonder about that, if, like, a guy has ever faked it with
me.
Oh,
yeah. I've said it on it. I told a story about
fake. It's easy to fake it
when you're using condoms. Right. Yeah, you can fake it. Because, like, I dribble a ton. I could fill a fucking condom with just my pre-cum.
I dribble a ton.
I fucking...
Like, you need a little dick bib.
Yeah.
Just tie around the head.
I mean, sometimes it feels good. I just, you know.
Pre-cum.
Like, if I've had a lot of sex in a night, like I've had like two, if I've gone two or three times, it might be so, like, I just might not be able to get it off.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm hard and I'm, it feels good. It's not like it doesn't,
that's normal,
good.
That happens,
but
with
I might,
all guys,
you know, and I might just want to, like, I'm like, oh, I just want to go to sleep, you know, so I'll just
well, just be honest, just be like, it's not gonna happen.
Yeah, but no, girls always take that as, oh, what was I doing wrong, I'm ugly.
Yeah,
that's what I'm telling
bitches,
you from
you
experience. Any girl I've ever been, like, been trying to be honest about that one particular thing,
yeah,
never a good thing to ever say that you ever. You fake it to make it, brother.
So you just fake it. You have the condom on, so it's, you can sell it.
Yeah.
All right. Okay.
I love absolutely. You.
I mean,
love you again, buddy. You can't do it if you don't have a condom on. You can't fake it.
Like, number one, the Southern gentleman, he can go anywhere from, like, 3 to 5 times in a sitting, in a night,
that's
over a large amount of time.
Wow, that's a fucking champ.
It's pretty impressive.
That's really impressive.
5 times max. And then after that, he'll go again, but he'll tell me, he's like, it's not going to happen. He's
right.
Like,
you just can't squeeze it out.
Yeah, the well is dry. Right. Like,
I mean, you can get,
like,
it up.
He'll still
you can
go
keep
for
it.
It. Exactly.
Right.
He'll still go for it, but he'll tell me, like, you know, it's,
right.
I'm done.
No, I can.
And that doesn't freak me out at all. I'm not like, oh, is it me? Like, I can't make gum for a 6th time. I must be ugly. No. He just.
Most girls are. Oh. Completely. Even if they
I'm
say that they will. They,
I'm so sorry you guys have,
like,
to deal with that
way.
Shit.
And, you know, and it's not like guys. It's so easy to get a guy off. You're not doing anything wrong, you know. I mean, there are girls that just lay there and it sucks, but I could still get off, even if you're just laying there like a fucking dead fish.
You just need the hole.
You know, right, exactly. I mean, there are things that'll turn you off, like if they smell bad or they're fucking just assholes. A dog could do what you do to my dick. Right, exactly my point. To make a female come, though, that's an art form. Mwah.
It is.
And it also helps when the girl is really into you, because you girls go into a place in your head where you can really make or break your orgasm.
No, we do.
Jesus.
Continue.
Like, if you want to orgasm with a dude, you can make yourself orgasm with any dude.
Well, they say that the woman's most powerful sex organ is her brain.
Yes.
Because we are so in our heads, and it takes nothing to, like, set us in a wrong direction.
Yes.
Even if you're in the middle of getting your brains fucked out, like, you can have a thought, or you can have, like, a worry about something that's going on, or
it won't come.
Yeah.
Or the other way around.
It could be like, oh my God, the light's on. Oh my God, I don't look good from this angle. Oh my God, I forgot to shave my legs. You know, it could be anything and just totally fucks you up.
But the other way is also true. Like, you could have got on Richie Richardson, and if you wanted, like, if you were, even with his little dick, if you were into him for some reason, like, you really thought he was hot or something, you could probably get yourself off.
Well,
even
that
with
too.
His little dick.
Even, like, talking dirty or just anything, like, just anything that stimulates my brain mentally, And again, if I was really into him or anything like that, anything right. that stimulates me right mentally, thing. You're absolutely right. That can push me right over the edge.
Right.
In a good way.
So, right, exactly. Well, that's my point, I think. Well, was there a point in any of that?
I don't think. There's never
not
a point
all.
In what we talk
not
about.
At all.
It's
all
right. We're discussing. We're sharing information.
What am I even talking about?
Let's hear from the fans.
Yeah!
It's time to answer your emails.
978-503-SUCK.
It's time to answer your emails.
978-503-SUCK.
Because remember when we, Angel, read the horoscopes and
yes, that was awesome.
And we asked the ladies.
Oh, yeah.
To write for us.
Did somebody come correct?
No.
Oh, boo.
What's going on? Why you stuck in bed? Hey, this is Randy from Missouri.
Who? Randy?
Hey, you know, y'all come out 2 episodes, you know, after your whole being gone for 2 months. Y'all come back, y'all are kicking ass. Fucking last 2 days, I'm trying to see if y'all have a new episode. Again, we're... You guys aren't back on the air, so
sorry,
you know,
pal.
What the hell's going on?
Motherfucker.
I still love the show, John Mull. You are a fucking god amongst mortal men, sir. You only have half the show dedicated to you. Sometimes when I'm listening, it's almost like I'm listening myself sometimes. You know, your thoughts and viewpoints are fucking spot on, sir. Don't fucking change. Paige, where do I get the naked pics? You sound hot as shit.
Thanks,
yeah,
baby.
Buddy.
You know, TP...
No naked.
You know, again, you too, my friend, are
you
a god amongst
shit.
Mortal men. Fucking keep rocking on, dude.
Yeah, buddy.
Other than that, you know, love show, just, you know, try to get back to a little bit more consistency, but, you know, would be awesome.
That's so true.
Fair enough.
So true.
Thank you. Keep it up. Make shows.
Fucking do your job.
Andy from Missouri.
Fuck bitches, make shows.
That's right.
Your accent is hot, baby. I love that southern accent. Wait, where is he from?
Missouri.
Oh, that's not southern.
I would love to...
God amongst mortal men.
Like, have a live...
Those are my boys he's talking about.
We should have a live taping and, like, sell tickets. And see if anyone
buys
tickets.
We would sell 3 tickets. Maybe, if we're lucky.
The problem is that I think, from what it sounds, our fans are completely... dispersed.
Yes.
Like,
yeah.
There's no concentration of...
Nope.
It, they're just all over the place.
We've got listeners in China.
Fucking hell.
13% of our listeners are in China.
Isn't
and
that
get
crazy?
This, 7% are in Afghanistan.
That's
really
insane.
I wonder if it's...
I wonder if it's true
military, bro.
Yeah,
I was going to say, it must be
See,
military.
We're
people.
Entertaining the troops, people.
There you go. Give them back.
Thank you for your service.
Because how cool would that be to, like, have, like, a live taping, right? With,
yeah.
like, let's say, I don't know, fucking, I don't know, 50 people, if we could even get that much. I don't even know if 50 people listen to the show, but... And then to go out and have drinks with all these, like,
oh
diverse
people. Oh, my God.
People.
I know.
How
that would be amazing.
Would that, be?
That would be great.
Like, just from the voicemails, we get so many different people
mm-hmm.
from different places. It would be so fucking cool to hang out with all these people.
It would be.
Because they all sound, like, awesome.
Absolutely.
Control Stacy in her bubble.
Yeah, seriously.
That being said, if any
Skype
of you
Henry
listeners are ever in the
face.
New York area, let us know.
Yeah. Yeah, like, people in New York, fucking
we
let us
We love
know.
You guys.
We totally come and hang out or tell you where, like, where a show is. And then...
Yeah, but then we wouldn't be able to hang out. Not that I wouldn't want the listeners to come to see me or,
oh, at your,
me or
at
TP
your
play. But, I mean, it would be... I'm totally down to, like, hang with the listeners at a bar. That'd be
cool.
great.
That would be cool.
We would. We would have to record it because I want live one-on-one retrospect from our listeners.
Yeah, that would be cool. Yeah, like their take on... Yeah, we'd have to interview them, you mean? Like do a...
Yeah,
do a Bruno,
that'd be awesome.
Like, man on the street.
Oh, yeah.
Show up with a yak back and be, like, speaking to the yak back. What was the, what
speaking
was the,
to my penis.
What was the name of the thing that... The little recorders that they sold in, like, the 90s. Wasn't it in Home Alone that he used for, like, the voices and shit?
Oh, like a Talk Boy or something
talk,
like that?
Talk, yeah, Talk Boy.
Yeah,
that might
I
be
remember
it.
That. I remember that.
I'll bring my Talk Boy. I think that was it. And then we can record.
Make sure you bring plenty of cassette tapes.
Yes, I will.
Well, that was the only email we got.
Well, that was a fucking good voicemail.
That was a good voicemail.
So,
Talk Boy, I'm looking.
Remember, email Stacy at riotcast.com or the phone
978-503.
Yes, look, it is Talk Boy. Remember this fucking thing?
How do I remember that? I'm so full of useless knowledge. Talk Boy, that's exactly
the
picture I had in my head too.
Bomb.com.
Holy shit!
Fucking hell! Look at that.
Don't show that to me while we're on the air.
That was awesome. All right. So what else? What's next? We got any articles?
Program. That's why we can't talk to him.
Yeah, but you would think he would at least reach out. I guess he can.
In the ass.
Miss you, Henry.
Me too. I used to be one of his handlers. I don't even have that job anymore.
Is he outsourced?
In the ass.
So, I have a question for you guys. Have you ever dated someone and then found out that one of your exes had contacted her to warn her about you?
Dated someone, one of my exes.
So you're dating somebody new, it's going great, and then you find out that one of your exes, who may or may not be crazy, contacted.
They're all crazy for me, so, yeah.
Well, I know.
This really doesn't count, but I'm going to say it anyway. When I was in high school, when I was a senior, my girlfriend was 16. So what was that, 10th grade or something? Like, she was younger than me?
Somewhere around there, yeah.
And when we broke up, I broke up with her right before I went away to college because I knew I was going to be going fucking away to college, mm-hmm. right? And I was still invited to her sweet 16. So I had the dilemma of, what do I do? If I don't go, I'm a dick because I already RSVP'd and whatever. But if I do go, I'm...
Those are legally binding, by the way.
But what I'm saying is, you can't win either way. If I go, then I'm the dick who broke up with her that still went to the birthday. But if I don't go, I'm a dick for canceling on her. So I took my best friend and I just went. I'm like, I'll go, I'll give a gift, I'll say hi, and I'll leave, right? But then when I got there, she had like a lot of hot friends there. Like, she was a cheerleader and shit. So mm-hmm. they were like, I'm like, oh, maybe I'll hang around for a little bit. And there was this one chick at one table that I was like, you know, totally flirting with a little bit. You know, I'm like, totally was getting good vibes off of her. And she came over to my table at one point, and I actually introduced myself, said hi, whatever. And she was totally flirting, totally. And I'm like, yeah. So she goes back to her table, and literally, I see my ex shoot over to her.
She was cock-blocking you.
Talking to her. They both look at me. And then later on, I'm like, shit, she said something. Later on the night, that same girl comes over to my table. And I was sitting with a group of guys. And she was like, listen, I really want to dance. Does anyone want to dance with me?
I'm like getting ready
to get up. And she's like, she looks at me. But then she looks at... another kid and is like, do you want to dance?
Oh, and he's like, man.
He's like, She asked everyone at the table except me. And no one said yes. And then she went back to the table. Now, I you know, of course, my best friend's like, bullshit. You know, she. I'm like, I'm telling you, that girl, that I just got cock blocked. He's like, bullshit, bullshit.
You totally.
Years did. Later, I became friends with this ex again. I went to her wedding like 3 or 4 years ago. And I asked her about that. I was like, I don't know if you're going to remember this. But when I went to your sweet 16, and she's like, oh, yeah, no, I remember you coming to my sweet 16. I'm like, yeah, but there was this girl, and she's like, oh, yeah, no, I totally know exactly what you're talking about. And I'm like, what did you say when you went over to that girl? Do you remember?
What did you say to her?
She's like, oh, I totally remember. I walked up to her, and I was like, listen, that's my ex-boyfriend. You better not even look at him the wrong way, or else I'll stab you in the neck.
Oh, so she wasn't warning her about you,
nope.
Like, oh, he's bad news, he sucks in bed, he's... Okay.
Straight up, I'm gonna kill you. So I don't know if that counts, but
that's still a good story.
That's the only time I could think of where that kind of thing has happened.
Well, Dr. Stacy found this awesome article on HuffingtonPost.com titled, Is It Your Job to Warn an Ex's New Flame? And I think just by kind of grazing over it...
No, absolutely not.
it's from the woman's standpoint or the ex-girlfriend standpoint.
Absolutely not. Not your business.
Well, let's see what she says. Many years ago, I find myself standing in my boyfriend's home, listening patiently as he argued with his ex on the phone. It was one of those petty discussions about absolutely nothing, a mere excuse for connection between two individuals struggling to let go of each other. At the time, I was the new girlfriend, and his ex had recently learned about me. Needless to say, she wasn't happy about the news of him moving on. She was screaming loud enough that I could hear her across the room. Does that woman have any idea what a horrible person you are? She asked. At that point, he opted to involve me in the conversation. Tara, he turned to me. Do you know how horrible I am? And I smiled and gave him a sarcastic, yeah. At that point, his ex decided to speak to me. Once we were connected, her angry tone dissipated as she embraced a more big sister kind of role. When I met him, I never thought he would ever hurt me, she confessed. At the time, I thought she was crazy and tried to contain my laughter. Well, then I told her, I guess you must have done something to deserve it.
Ooh, bitch.
Damn, girl.
I would have kicked her right in the twat.
They're on the phone. To this day, I have no idea what her intentions were. Did she honestly want to warn me about the dangers of getting involved with the man who had caused her so much pain? Or was she just trying to scare me away in hopes that they might reconcile? It doesn't matter. The point of my story is, don't bother trying to warn a new woman about your ex.
It's never going
to
work.
You might have the best of intentions. Perhaps you really do want to save her the trouble and heartache that you've come to know so well. However, chances are that your advice will fall on deaf ears, and here's why. She doesn't want to hear it. The relationship is new and exciting, and when they're together, she feels exhilarated and happier than she's been in all her life. Your ex is currently fulfilling the role of man of her dreams, and she can't imagine him as anything else.
And she's also like, it's going to be different with me. I'm better than you.
Unfortunately, women do think that, yes. Your well-intentioned warning of his dark side will come as an unwelcome buzzkill. If she were here to hear you at all, she'd likely reject your advice because it conflicts with everything her heart tells her. Mm-hmm. She won't give you any credit. In their love story, she's Cinderella and he's Prince Charming. Who are you? You're the bitter ex, and unfortunately, your experience doesn't count for much in her mind. He probably told her that you were a terrible partner and he suffered miserably for most of the time you were together.
Mm-hmm.
It's realistic to assume that she thinks you're jealous of her age, beauty, and happiness. Why on earth should she listen to you? She needs to make and learn from her own mistakes. Remember when you thought your parents were old fuddy-duddies who knew nothing? They probably warned you about a lot of things and yes. You had to find out for yourself, didn't you? She yep. does too. You might be wrong. What if the new woman is truly better suited to build a life with your ex? The possibility exists that she's a more compatible partner than you were. As time goes by, she might bring out the best in him, and that will likely make things better for you.
Probably not, but yeah, that's a possibility.
The cold hard truth is, once you and your ex have separated, his relationships are none of your business.
Yes.
As a mother, you might have every right to be concerned about your children's comfort and safety with the new woman. But as an angry, wounded, bitter, smarter ex, you have no right to counsel another adult about her choice in romantic partners. The good news is, while you're not busy worrying about your ex's new flame, you have more time to think about yourself. Keep learning from your own experiences, and you can look forward to greater happiness in your own life.
Totally good advice.
I think that's very good advice.
I've actually reveled and enjoyed seeing my ex, one particular one, with new guys. Because as you know, in our band, mm-hmm. I used to date the bass player's sister.
Mm-hmm.
And she's bipolar, borderline, whatever, crazy, my par from the course
exactly
for me.
Your type.
So when it
dream girl.
When it ended with us, and she would bring her new guy around to our shows, and Barney would say, hey, did you see, you know, beeps, new guy. He's got a look of fear on his face. I would love it.
You would.
And I would go over to him and say, hey, nice to meet
shake
you.
Shake his hand.
Or she would introduce me, and I would just whisper in his ear, run. He'd go, what?
Nothing. Nice
you'll
to meet
find
you.
Out. You'll find out, buddy. I would love it. I wouldn't warn them. I don't know him. I don't give a fuck what happens to him. I just know what he's in for.
Right.
And I love it.
Have fun leave it with at that.
Yeah. Run, buddy.
Enjoy that shit.
Mazel tov.
Exactly.
Excellent.
You'll know one day when you said
work. Actually, funny enough, one of my more recent exes, when I met her brothers, were like I hung out with them and they were cool. Like they were also ex-frat guys mm-hmm. and stuff like that. And like we hung out. And at one point in the night, one of them took me aside and was like, "Listen, you seem like a pretty cool dude. You know, our sister's crazy, right?" Like, I swear.
Yeah, but you know what? That seems less. That doesn't seem quite so. What's the word I'm looking for? Just like.
There's no ulterior motive.
Thank you. That's exactly what I was trying to say. That's just like bro code. That's just she's crazy. Yes. I'm not saying not to date her. I'm just saying, you know, she's crazy.
Right.
Guys will do that for each other. Women, there's
and
always an underlying.
They were being completely sincere.
I'm sure they were.
I knew she was crazy, though. I just thought I could work around the crazy.
I don't know. You can't be a girl and try to warn your ex's new whatever and not come off as crazy.
And not come off as a bitch.
Well, that too. I can honestly and happily say I've never done that. I've never been like, oh, you got to watch out for him. And I, whoever ends up with my ex, God bless
sucks,
you.
Right, sucks to be
God
you,
God bless you.
Sucks to be you. No, I feel the same way. You'll find out how shitty they are eventually.
Right,
so.
Exactly. And you know what? Like the article says, maybe that new maybe person will turn them
the
around.
Shitty. Right.
You know, maybe they'll turn that person around. And again, more power to you. You know, it's no point in carrying that around for the rest of your life. Resentment for somebody that you're not even with anymore.
Exactly.
Let that shit go.
Right, and because eventually you're going to find someone better anyway. So
exactly.
Fuck them.
Everything happens for a reason.
They go fuck themselves.
What you
all them
there,
exes
fella?
Out there, go fuck yourselves. And I mean, even like, and eventually, like, at least in my case, 99% of the time, like, I end up getting on good terms with my exes.
Me too.
I don't
me
like
too. Well,
that
just shows your character, though, too. You're not like a bitter douchebag. You're not.
I don't like having enemies out there.
And what's the point of wasting energy on hating somebody and
right.
making them your
Why
enemy?
Bother?
Exactly.
Like my ex-wife, like we get along now, and you know,
that's
of
a beautiful
course,
thing.
That's important because of the kids, but. Beyond that, it's more of a case of, you know what, we weren't good for each other.
Right.
So you go find
someone. And you're still going to be in each other's lives, so you might as well be civil right. to each other.
You go find someone better suited for you, I'll find someone better suited for
mm-hmm.
me, and that's it. And we can be happy for each other, whatever.
I'm proud of you, kid.
You know.
Good job.
But my more recent ex can burn in the fire pits of, fucking
of Hades.
Hades.
What do we got?
TP just handed me an article titled, Bradenton Woman Arrested After Fight with Twin Sister Over Vibrator, Boyfriend.
Is this, where's Bradenton? Is that Florida?
That's Western Florida, my friend.
Yes. I feel like I should have known that.
A Bradenton woman was arrested Sunday afternoon after getting into a fight with her twin sister about a vibrator and her boyfriend, according to the Manatee County Sheriff's Office.
Manatee?
Manatee County.
Manatee County.
Yes. Everything in Florida is manatee, dolphin.
Manatee.
Do you know what a manatee is?
The sea elephant.
Yes, exactly.
The county
sea cow.
Is named after the sea cow.
Yes,
the
it is.
The sea elephant.
And everything in that area, I've been down there. Everything, Jeff knows you've been down there. Everything down there is
sea themed.
Manatee themed. It's like yeah.
manatee
it's
themed?
Like Manatee Hospital, Manatee
really?
Memorial Bridge, manatee diner.
It drives everything. People crazy. It drives them to do stuff
it
like
must.
This.
Exactly.
It must.
Heidi Creamer. That's
nice.
Her name.
Really?
That's awesome.
That sounds like a porn name.
See, a name like that would make you crazy.
That
Heidi Creamer
like
started fighting with her twin at 1:38 p.m.
What's the twin's name?
If you interrupt me one more fucking
oh
time.
Oh, my God.
Fighting over Heidi's boyfriend and a sexual toy, parentheses, vibrator. And the verbal argument soon turned to blows, according to a probable cause affidavit. Nice choice of words, news. Creamer punched her sister in the face in the foyer of the apartment, knocking her to the floor, the report said. The victim then started kicking Creamer away as Creamer punched, scratched, and pulled her twin's hair. Creamer stopped after a few minutes and began grabbing her personal belongings, stacking them outside the front door, and stating that she wanted to leave, according to the affidavit. When Creamer exited the front door to place some items outside, her twin slammed the door and locked Creamer outside.
Good move.
When a deputy arrived on the scene, the twin sister was on the balcony of her apartment with blood on her face, where she had been yelling to neighbors to call the police. Creamer was banging on the front door, screaming obscenities, and yelling at the officer. the scream. Oh, God, it kills me.
Take that, Creamer.
Oh, my God, make it stop. The deputy handcuffed Creamer, citing safety concerns about Creamer's aggressive behavior, and placed her in the back of the patrol vehicle.
It's like your tongue gave up at the end of that word.
The screams just mentally exhausted me. Vehicle.
Vehicle. The vehicle. The most certainous.
Buffy, put her in the back of the vehicle. When the deputy read Creamer her Miranda rights, Creamer began screaming that she was fighting. You're such a dick. That she was fighting with her sister over a vibrator and her boyfriend. Creamer then refused to speak to the officer.
Selfish.
Creamer is being charged with domestic battery and was taken to Manatee County Jail. See, I told
Jesus.
You. She was released on bond.
I wonder if she had to choose between the two, which she had rather had.
Between the boyfriend and the vibrator?
And the vibrator, yeah.
Well,
She wanted both.
Which was, yeah, which was more important to her happiness?
I don't think I could even answer that question.
Really? Even with stud number one?
Well, he's not always around.
It's true.
Oh, the vibrator is always there for
That's
you.
That's true.
That's true.
I don't know, I'm kind of leaning towards vibrator. Mm. What you got for me there, fella?
Did you get it off at twistedtoys.net?
Of course I did. I took it out of my own warehouse.
Do you get the 20% discount?
When Honey, I get way more than the 20% discount.
You get a five-finger discount. What?
I have...
At 80 to that 20.
Exactly. Stuart man arrested after masturbating outside because mother won't let him watch porn inside. I already love this article.
Take that, Mom.
Fuck you, Mom. A Stuart man was arrested on an exposure of sexual organs after he was seen masturbating in his yard, reported on the Offbeat blog. That whole sentence just totally...
Ma, you won't let me masturbate? Ma, let me back in! I want to masturbate!
The meatloaf. Anthony Smith, 21, told police his mother won't let him watch porn in the house, so instead he goes outside nude and walks around hoping that someone will see him, according to the arrest affidavit.
What?
Go to this blog for the full story. Oh my God, look at him. That's Anthony Smith. Can you picture that walking around?
Naked.
Ma!
Two people said they saw him standing in the yard and he had no clothes on and was masturbating. So homeboy is just standing in his yard, buck ass naked, jerking himself off. Just standing in the yard.
But and he still doesn't have porn.
What's he looking at?
You're not winning. Does the tree look like it has a boob?
What if he was... Oh, can you imagine if he was like looking, like locked eyes with you as you're like coming out of your house and just like,
I need something to look at.
That would creep me out.
Yeah, between you and that anthill that looks like a boob.
So that knot in the tree that looks like a vagina. So, obviously, they call the cops, and he told the cops that his mom won't let him watch pornography in the house.
Therefore, like, it's okay.
What a little bitch.
Police, you can go.
And then, like, the cops with those guys fucking on the dead bodies. But did you get off?
Excuse me, did you finish?
Did you finish? That's all we want to know.
Because you're still completely hard. I'm just curious. Were you at least able
to put it in the report?
Right.
He told people that walking around outside and hoping that somebody will see him gets him high.
Gets him
he's
high?
He's an exhibitionist. That's all he is.
Doesn't he mean hard?
No, he gets like off on the prospect of somebody seeing him walk around his yard naked.
So he's a fucking...
He's an exhibitionist.
Pervert, I was gonna
say. Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's true, but, you know, who am I to judge?
What if a fucking little kid sees him or something?
Well, yeah, that's fucked up. I didn't even think about that.
Merry Christmas!
Feliz Navidad!
Dreaming of a wild...
See, it's too cold here for us to walk around our yards and masturbate.
Just like the ones I used to know. Oh, yeah, this episode goes up like the day before Christmas.
Welcome
it?
To the program, Johnimal. Thank you. Thanks for coming. Thanks for showing up.
But the fans will be happy to know we could probably tape that week. I have a couple of grocery days off that week for the holiday.
Do you?
Yeah. You better start thinking about when your ass can come down from Connecticut and fucking do this shit.
Well, hopefully I don't get another rim job.
Andy is upset with us.
Poor Andy.
And I don't blame him.
We don't want to make Andy upset.
I don't blame him.
I don't either.
Guy's pretty solid.
Well, if Andy feels that way, that means other people do too. So we gotta come correct.
He's a solid dude.
We gotta keep this shit going.
And then there was Lee and there's...
So we're planning on Christmas week?
Nope. I'm going to be heading down south for my sex slave.
Oh, shit. Are you going to Bradenton? Are you going to go hook up with this 21-year-old D? I'm going to Manatee County.
Are you coming back for New Year's? You're spending New Year's.
State the Manatee Motor Inn.
I come back New Year's Eve night.
Motherfucker.
I'm going to be around for New Year's. Well, listen, fans, we're not going to let you down again. One way or another, we're going to get this podcast up.
We're trying to put this all together for you people?
Yeah, so you're witnessing
usually
this.
Usually Dr. Stacy
maybe
does
next,
this.
Maybe next
now
week.
Now three
usually
weeks
these are discussions we have off air, so
what about
sorry,
the
guys.
Monday before?
Wait, let me get on my schedule.
I'm off from the grocery store, I think. No, I'm off that Tuesday. Fuck. Oh, we'll talk about it off air. Yeah. All right, so anything, anything more?
We took you behind the scenes.
Why don't we talk about our sponsors, boys?
Oh, we have sponsors.
We do, and they're fabulous.
I know the TwistedToys.net sponsor.
Fuck yeah, baby.
Sitting right next to me with that wonderful little company of yours, racking in the fucking holiday money.
Oh, yeah. And TwistedToys.net. Toys with a Z. Enter the code SUCK for 20% off.
Yeah, you want to cash in on that 20% off? You put in that SUCK. You get that 20%. And then all the shit you're going to buy, not the sex stuff, because you're buying all that from twistedtoys.net, but all the other shit.
Literally everything
all
else.
All the other shit. You go on Amazon.com.
Amazon.com.
Click our little fucking thingamajigger. Where is that, Jeff?
Oh,
that
Jesus
little jigger?
Riotcast.com/whyyousuckinbed.
Yeah.
Or click the banner at the top of the page.
Yeah, a little banner thing.
That'll take you right to Amazon.
Go to the Amazon Prime. Get your last minute Christmas gifts.
Order all that shit. And, yeah, we get, like, a couple of cents from that. It's awesome.
Tweaked audio.
Yeah. So don't order your earbuds off of Amazon. Order it off of Tweaked Audio.
Because with the code SUCK, you get 33%
off. 33% off. And don't get your video games off of Amazon. You can get those off of Gamefly.com.
/SUCK for a 30-day free trial.
Yeah, yeah.
30 whole days free.
And that's a month.
That's a whole month.
You think they have Mike Tyson's Punch-Out?
Oh, that's a good question, actually.
Can I get Nintendo cartridge games for the NES system?
I know they have a lot of systems, games. I don't know if they have Nintendo, like old-ass Nintendo games.
Old-ass Nintendo.
Yeah, I was actually going to say I ordered an old...
You can also leave us a voicemail.
Yeah. 978-503-SUCK.
I ordered an old Super Nintendo game off of Amazon.
Follow us on Twitter. Like us on Facebook.
I hate both of you.
At Why You Suck in Bed.
Something.
Well, I hope you guys all have an awesome holiday.
Drink a lot of eggnog, get drunk, and bang each other.
Dreaming of why.
I held that. You hear me hold that note?
Christmas.
Oh, that was nice, yes.
Just like the ones
you're a crooner.
I used to know.
Hold that note.
Can you hear me yacking my face off in the background?
Get all the
Jesus
background
Christ.
Noise out.
No.
Listen, if any of you listeners get a pair of vibrating panties for Christmas, I want you to tweet me a photo at Twisted Toys immediately.
And a review.
Yeah, reviews
I
are always good.
I want to know, like, stories about these toys that you're using with each other. Like, are they good? Are they bad? Is it working?
Yes, and if you can rate us on iTunes, that helps us out.
Yeah,
five stars on iTunes, please. We will love you forever and continue
Wouldn't
to
that
love
be
you.
Fun? To get some vibrating panty stories?
We're way past that now.
I want vibrating panties.
We'll try to come back soon.
Thank you all for listening. We fucking love you guys. Thank you for the ratings. Thank you for the emails and the voicemails. Keep them coming. We will see you next Tuesday.
Love you.